Let's do the design of this detergent bottle with a free CAD software. After seeing that video from Riley Brown tutorial using Blender 3D, then I'm thinking if it can be modeled with a CAD software. So here we go. In this tutorial, I will use Onshape to create this model, but I can assure you that you can use the same techniques and tips with other free CAD software, such as Fusion 360, like this. And even with FreeCAD, like this. And of course, with any other CAD software such as SolidWorks Inventor, PTC Creo. So let's get started. Log into your Onshape account and let's import the reference picture first. You can download the picture in the link in the description below. After importing the image, let's create a new Onshape document and insert the image on the front plane. So, insert image, go to the document of a reference picture, then click 2 times and draw image rectangle. Adding dimension and constraint is up to you. For the next step, let's draw the main outline, which are the top profile, the bottom profile, the two sides curve and the middle line to join the middle profile and the other side. Use lines and splines for the outline and adjust it to match the reference picture. Next, let's create the top part, which is an arc. Create a new plane first by using plane point and choose the top plane and a point on the top profile, and let's create a sketch on this new plane. Use the top line as a diameter and draw the arc. Add a point on the middle of the arc, vertical to the center of the arc. We need it later. After that, choose the top plane and let's create the bottom profile. Use the bottom line and convert it into a construction line. Thank you. Then draw a spline and adjust it like an ellipse. Add point to the spline and make it vertical to the point from the middle line that touch the bottom profile. Next, use the right plane to draw a spline to join the two profiles on the other side. Adjust the spline to be more curvy to the outside, like a bottle. Then, use this sketch and the middle line from sketch 2 as a 3D sketch by using projected curve 2 sketches. Now, let's create our first surface by using loft surface. Use sketch 3 and sketch 4 as profile and use the splines from sketch 2 and the projected curve as guides. Then, offset surface 1 to the inside by the distance of 3.5 mm. Let's choose the front plane and draw two circles following the reference picture. After that, click on Split Faces and choose the face to split respectively with the two circles, the small circle for the offsetted surface and the large one for the first surface. Then, delete faces that we don't need. Use again loft surface add to join the two faces. Next, show again the image and let's sketch on the front plane this curve. Use spline and adjust it to match the image. Create a new plane and offset the front plane to the inside for a distance of 1.5 mm and sketch the handle hole. After that, use again the split command and use the last two sketches as a split tool and split the circle face. Edit the handle hole and add these lines. We need it later. Then delete these faces. Next, draw these edges as one curve by using composite curve. After that, delete the other faces. Now, let's extrude these lines. We need that faces to be splitted later. Choose the top plane and let's draw two arcs to join the point from the main surface to the point from the handle hole. And split these faces with that arcs. Do the same with the top part of the handle. Next, let's create a middle guide curve. Choose the top plane and draw an arc to join the middle of the arc and the middle of the composite curve. After that, choose the right plane and draw another arc joining the middle of the arc and the middle of a composite curve. And project two sketches as 3D curve. Repeat that steps for the bottom curve. Now, let's join everything. Use the composite curve and arc from the handle as profile and use the rest as guide like this. Repeat the same process for the bottom surface. After that, delete the useless body and use Boolean Union to join all the surfaces. Fill the empty part of the handle by using Loft. And the bottleneck. Mirror all the surface to create the whole body. Patch the handle. And the bottom using loft and fill command. Turn the surface into a solid by using thicken command and add some fillet, and our bottle shape is almost done. The rest is easy, just a basic extrude for the mouth of the bottle and extrude and shell for the lid. To sum up, we mostly use loft, split, composite curve, projected curve and tilted face to design this bottle. Thanks for watching and see you for the next video.